is section B of the spring routine class. So it starts with three swing outs in a circle. Looks like this. One, two, three, and four, five, six, seven. A one, two, three, and four, five, six, seven. A one, two, three, and four, five, six, seven. And the circle. Three, and four, five, six, seven. From there we go into basic Charleston, just one. And then we go into tandem. Rock, step, kick, and boom, ba, boom, ba, and two basics in tandem. Here's our second one. We do a pop out for the follow, just a normal pop out and back in. On the second one, we bring her back to our side. Boom, da, boom, da, boom, da, da. We finish our basic Charleston here, and then a double rock step leads us into section C, but we'll do that on the C video. So the key parts here, three swing outs in a circle, you guys know. Just make sure you have a nice even rhythm. We were talking to follows a little bit about their swivels. Maybe try putting some of those in there and practicing those. But nice, clean leading and following. And then for tandem Charleston, that's probably the spot that people might need help. So for tandem, why doesn't Jen, do you want to say your footwork first?
Sure.
So Jen will say the follows footwork first. Here we go. Five, six, seven.
Rock, step, kick, step, kick, step, rock, step, kick, step, rock, step, left.
Good. Now the lead's footwork is almost exactly the same except for just one little spot, which is on. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. We just do a kick step while they do a rock step. I'll say the lead's footwork. Rock, step, kick, step, kick, step, rock, step, kick, step, and one, two, three. We worked a bit on that idea of as soon as you go into tandem, just practicing this muscle memory, getting your left foot back and your left arm forward. One, two, three, four. We also worked on the posture of tandem, where if you're just bent slightly at the waist with your partner, it's a lot less likely that you're gonna stomp on your partner's feet. And is that everything for tandem?
I think so.
Okay, so then the little pop out, we worked on the footwork for this. Why don't we do the follows footwork first? The first part of the pop out is pretty simple. We'll do that one first. Just do one basic
rock
to start.
Step, kick.
That's fine.
That's the basic. Rock step, kick step, rock step, kick step, rock step, kick step, rock step, kick step.
Yeah. So they're just doing rock step, kick steps. And then as a lead, I'm just doing my normal footwork whenever I'm doing those pop outs. And then whenever we do the second pop out for the follows, maybe we'll have follows footwork first. Five, six, seven,
rock step, kick step.
So this is the second pop out.
Kick step, rock step, kick step, kick step, rock step, right.
For leads there, you are doing
five, six, seven.
We'll just do a basic here. So pretend this is the second pop out.
I do rock step, kick and rock step.
So I just do a double kick on the right to get her back into close. And I think that's all the tricky stuff. The only thing is at the very end of that, when you do one basic Charleston, when you come back together, one, two, three, four. From here, we're gonna do rock step. It goes five, six, seven, eight, and that just gets it back on time to go into section C, which we're gonna do next.